Hey everyone, Ariel Adams here with the aBlogtoWatch. Please subscribe to our videos on YouTube and like this video if you find it useful. Also hit the bell to be notified of our upcoming videos. This is a review of the Ball Engineer Hydrocarbon Original. This is one of the newer versions of the Engineer Hydrocarbon, which is a range that's been around almost since the relaunch of Ball several years ago. The Hydrocarbon was designed to be a sort of hyper-modern with a bit of a retro theme twist dive watch series that incorporated cool technology and had an interesting look, and is always typified by this I'm not even sure if it actually does something, but you press it in here and you lift up the ability to screw out the crown. So it's a type of a crown guard, but it's sort of for show, but it definitely adds a character to the watch that I like. So what's original about this? Well, I guess the original thing is they're trying to homage the Rolex Submariner dial in a very Ball way. So the other versions of the Hydrocarbon would have a very different dial. This one does this, and this the reason that I believe Ball made a dial like this for the first time in the original was because they used a new technology in this watch, and that is a dial that uses flat tritium gas tubes in a sandwich dial. So sandwich style dials are where there's a top layer and then the bottom layer is painted with luminant, and then the top layer has some holes cut out so that you can have hour markers. And that's basically exactly how this dial works, but rather than the lower layer having luminant, it has these tritium gas tubes that are more flat. So they don't look like the cylindrical tubes like you have in the hands. They look like traditional loomed hour markers, which is fascinating, and you have those in the dial and in the rotating bezel. The rotating bezel is topped with a sapphire crystal, which is an uncommon element, and this is probably one of the more affordable watches that has a sapphire crystal inlay over the bezel, as well as of course over the dial. Ball says this watch is 40 millimeters wide. I don't know why, because if you measure the bezel, it's 42 millimeters wide. So maybe part of this is 40 millimeters, but if you see that number, that's a little bit misleading in my opinion, because this is definitely wears more like a 42 millimeter. It's about 14 and a half millimeters thick. And what I found very interesting is when I compared this watch to an older hydrocarbon model, I found that the cases, while similar looking, were actually different. And Ball has been quietly, or I guess maybe not so quietly, it's quiet to me, upgrading the hydrocarbon case to make it better looking, more ergonomic, and more comfortable to wear. And that's actually a really nice thing. A special feature of Ball watches that I always find amusing is continued on the back here. You can see here there's a sort of a relief image of a diver wearing, a light on his head. Ball always takes a diver and some random picture, seemingly random picture, to engrave on the back of these watches. So it's like they're the same across the same models, but each model has like this different random picture on the back. And it's like you never know what it's going to be. It only remotely goes with the theme of the watch. And it's just one of those amazing quirks. And I'm just like, what made them choose that picture, that angle? I'm not even sure exactly what this has to do with this watch design, but it's fine. It's part of the fun. One of the greatest stories about this watch is actually the movement. And it's a base, Swiss ETA, and Ball calls it the RR1102-CS2. What does that mean? Well, the base, automatic mechanical movement, it's also COSC Chronometer-certified, has two pretty important things in there. One is called spring seal, and that is a technology. It's actually, I don't know if it's part of the movement, it's actually part of the crown system, I believe, to keep water and dust and things like that out of the watch, and that's a special proprietary system. And spring lock is a vibration reduction system, which is designed to reduce error that can happen in timing when the watch is subject to extreme vibrations. And this was developed by Ball some years ago, and it's actually not too common to have it in the watches. And what it does is it puts a little cage around the balance spring. That's why it's called spring lock. And it literally prevents the spring from moving around too much if it's subject to vibration. And apparently that was enough to reduce error. And so that's a special little feature that this watch has, which is interesting and you wouldn't really know. It's also pretty highly anti-magnetic. And like I said, it's a COSC chronometer. The watch is water resistant to 200 meters, which I don't know why 200 meters, because Ball's other watches are often 300 meters water resistant. Not like that really matters for me functionally, because 200 meters is just fine. But I just sort of noticed that they're like they're more like this. I know, I think of this as being a little bit more of an extreme watch. Isn't as water resistant, but again, it doesn't matter. One of the things is the bracelet is really nice, but for me, I'm never able to find it the exact right size. That's entirely related to my anatomy, but I do like that they include half links here, as well as these little micro adjusts, and there's one on each side of the bracelet. So the bracelet isn't new, this is the way the bracelet's always been, but it's nice that you have these two sides of micro adjust. And why would you want to have these for comfort? But if you're wearing this over a wetsuit and you opened up both of them, you would have probably enough to wear it over the wetsuit. And it says Ball design there on the clasp. This is a nice clasp, and it's a little bit more interesting looking than a lot of the stuff at the same price point. So let's put the watch back on there. And again, it's kind of funny that they say this is 40 millimeters, because it doesn't wear or feel at all like 40 millimeters. And sometimes brands do that. They don't mean harm or anything like that. They're just not always sure exactly what measurement, because sometimes the side of the watch to the end of the crown, that's never used, but that's obviously more. Sometimes it's the case. Sometimes it's the back of the case. Is it the bezel? I like to measure it from bezel edge to bezel edge. Whatever that is for me is the width of the watch. I don't include the crown. Some people do. So it's just one of the things you have to sort of see the watch on people's wrists. I find that the Ball Engineer Hydrocarbon has always been one of my favorite sport watch collections, especially since there's so many cool technical features, the tritium gas tube. Sometimes they do fun stuff with the movement as here. The overall sort of fit and finish feels really good. So I like these a lot. The original has probably the most elegant dial, because it has that Submariner look, and the fact that you don't see the tritium gas tubes as much does make it a little bit more classic looking and a little bit more classy. So that's, you know, definitely something to consider, because you want a watch that's elegant and can be worn in a slightly more formal setting, and so that's nice. And again, it looks cool, and the sapphire crystal over the bezel, always a nice feature for durability. So again, this is the Ball Engineer Hydrocarbon Original. Price is $3,249, and you can see the full review on the Blog to Watch. Thanks.